Hey there and welcome to the Uke Stuff channel. Today's video is a tutorial for the ukulele playalongs of Ed Sheeran's Happier. Don't get it confused with the version of Happier by Marshmello. This was a request. There is in the description below a tri-setter where you can upvote video suggestions. And this song was suggested and it had a four chord pattern that I thought this would be great. But I do want to do a little bit of a content warning. For a school, some of the lyrics may not be 100% appropriate, so just be aware of that as you go. Now, with these tutorials, first of all, we'll look at the chords for G, C, E, A, ukulele. Then we'll look at the chords for baritone, D, G, B, E, ukulele. And then we'll talk some strumming and picking for the song. Also, I want to remind you that you can jump ahead to timestamps below in the description to things that matter to you. And want to remind you that this channel has a collaboration with UkuTabs, where you can find the tabs used to create this video. Tabs meaning the chord chart, not the actual written ukulele tabs. All right, let's begin with the chords that you need for G, C, E, A ukulele. I will be using my Lava Music Lava U, rather new ukulele on the market. So there are only four chords you need to worry about, and most of the time, only three. The first chord is the A minor chord. Then the F chord. Then the C chord. And then at one point in the song, at the very end, you'll need a G a few times. And those are the four chords you need for G, C, E, A, ukulele. Let's take a look at the chords you need for baritone D, G, B, E, ukulele. I'll be using my one and only baritone. This is my mainland baritone cedar top, rosewood, back and sides. The first chord you need is the A minor chord. Then you're going to need the F chord. Again, don't let the F freak you out. Make sure you're holding your ukulele securely with your right arm, pending that you're a right-handed player. Left hand will cover strings 1 and 2 right at the first fret, and then pull against the fretboard. And then just lightly touch underneath. And you should get the clear sound you need in those strings, and then add the other two fingers that you need for the F major chord. And yes, it can be difficult, but don't make it any harder than it needs to be. Then we have the C chord. And then at the very end of the song, you have a few instances of the G chord. And those are the four chords you need for D, G, B, E, baritone ukulele on this song. Now, as it comes to strumming, I always want to remind people that there is no right answer for the song. Ed Sheeran did not use ukulele in the original version, so you're never going to completely match what the guitar does. So you have some freedom to do what works best for you, and if you don't like these suggestions, don't use them. Make up your own. That's totally okay. So what I hear in this song is really, well, three different things. There are some points where you get single strums. I'm not even going to talk about those. Pretty straightforward. However, I do hear some picking, and I do hear a chance for some strumming, so I'm going to talk about each of those. Now, on my GCEA ukulele, it's tuned high G. It's re-entrant is what we call it, because you have a G above middle C, then middle C, E, and then A above the first G. That's called re-entrant tuning. And as such, it's going to sound a little different if you have a low G, which we just call linear tuning, or a baritone ukulele like my baritone that's going to be tuned, you know, in a linear fashion with this fourth string, the one closest to you, being lower than the others. I'll talk about playing this on a linear tuning in just a second. Let's talk about how I would play finger picking on high G tuned GCEA ukulele. So the number one technique that I use almost all the time, and it almost always sounds good, I took from Mike Lynch. Again, a wonderful man, passed away a couple years ago, but he left a legacy of his lessons online for us to look at. And he talked about starting a strumming pattern by using your thumb, first finger, and second finger on strings 4, 2, and 1. And you pluck them all at the same time, all right? And then you pluck whatever else you want to pluck. Now, when I'm playing this, what I find myself doing is this. So I'm going 4, 2, 1, then my thumb plays 3, 2, 1, okay, in terms of string order, 3, 2, 1, or it's my thumb, first finger, second finger. So if I'm on A minor, that's what I do. Then I switch to the F. Then I do the same thing with the C. So then with the C chord, I find myself extending the pattern a little bit. So I play 4, 2, 1, then 3, 2, 1, 4, 3, 2, 1. It sounds like this. And then sometimes I'll also do this. I'll play 4, 2, 1, then 3, 2, 4, 1, 3, 2, 1. And then that sounds like this. And put that into full speed. So it could either go like this, that last one is the version where you play the C chord, 4, 2, 1, 3, 2, 4, 1, 4, 2, 3, or you can do this. Come right back to it again. It really doesn't matter what you do as long as you fill the time right, and that's a couple ideas with picking. Now let's take a look at that on baritone ukulele just for a moment. Now with baritone ukulele, a lot of it's going to be the same. So with the A minor chord, I'd still go 4, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, then change, then your C chord. So try that. And notice my thumb is always playing strings 3 and 4. First finger is always playing 2. Second finger is always playing string 1. So again, that C chord sounds pretty good. So if you do that whole sequence, pretty well on linear tuning going that way. So when it comes to strumming, let's make this pretty simple. On the A minor chord, you're just going to go down, down, up. F chord, down, down, up. And then the C, you're going to do the island strum, which is down, down, up, up, down, up. All right, let's just play that a few times. A minor, F, C. Minor, F, C. One more time. A minor, F, C. And that's going to work pretty well most of the time when you need to do a strum in the song, other than simple down strums. And you can do whatever you want. Usually for just the down strum, I use my thumb because I like the quality of the tone that you get with your thumb. And believe it or not, that's it. That's all you need for this song. And that's even looking at it a little harder than you have to. If you want to, you can just play down strums for the whole song. It doesn't matter. But if you want to try some of that picking, there it is for you. If you want to try some of that strumming, that's why it's there for you too. So thanks for watching the video. Again, thank you to the person that recommended the song on the Trisetter. We appreciate it. And I will be back soon with some more uke stuff for you.